Hey, story come to bump. Well, this past come to bump. The man has officially been charged. Welcome to Soul Flow TV again, everybody. It's your host with the most. I told you so. I told you so a week ago. Look at the last video that I did leading up to this, and I did not release any more information concerning that case because I was asked by the person who gave me that information to please hold off. Don't say nothing more. Don't put out the rest of the voice note them. Don't do anything. Just wait. And now, after this, him said, just wait, man. It'll come. Now, after them charge him, then me, I go give you some real history and some real story. So, people, look forward to the real history and the real story. Anyway, as I woke up this morning, I went to two places to search for this. One of my subscribers said, SoFlo, Beachy got charged. I don't know if you know it already. I guess you probably heard it already. Well, thank you very much, subscriber. I was on the road at the time and I hadn't heard it. Anyway, according to, and this is straight from the Jamaica Constabulary Force, Portland businessman charged with wife's murder is the headline. Printed by the Jamaica Constabulary Force on their social media page. And it says that August 19th, 2020, detectives assigned to Major Organized Crime Investigation Division officially charged 65-year-old businessman Everton McDonald of Dolphin Court, Dolphin Bay, Port Antonio, Portland, otherwise called Beachy Stout or Mr. Mac, was charged with the murder of his wife on Tuesday, August 18th. Officially, today is August 19th. I don't know if y'all know it, but SOE, state of emergency, was lifted yesterday in some places. I guess, or was it island-wide? I don't know yet, but I know that it was lifted. And based on that, a lot of people who were detained were let go if they didn't have any charges to levy against them. In the case of Mr. Beachy Stout, once Mrs. Tammy Lee get let go and other people came out and Mr. Beachy Stout was still in custody, I already knew and I was waiting on it some more, and here it was. Also charged with Mr. Beachy Stout McDonald are 30-year-old Astor Brains, otherwise called Tiny, of Epsom District, and then Anata Bay, St. Mary, and 56-year-old Denvalin Minot, otherwise called Bubble, which is a fisherman of Ranch. Now, hear this, about the fisherman, you know, I have a lady where I tell me, say, so Florida, fisherman, they are not him do it, but he might tell everything where him know still. Anyhow, we'll see how this goes in the end. The men were jointly charged by the police with murder and conspiracy to murder following the intense investigation following the discovery of Hamilton McDonald's burnt body where she was found on the roadway. We don't have to talk in details about what happened to the wife and gruesome murder and all these things. We're not going into that in this video. We're moving forward and talking about where the case sits now. Imagine this, like father, like son. Andreen McDonald left Earth the same way at the hands of Beachy Stout's son. And then, of course, the father the same way. Now, there are talks about them reopening the investigation into the suspicious circumstances under which his first wife was also made to leave Earth. Let's put it that way, for lack of a better term, right? So he could very well be charged with double murder anytime soon. But make quick talk. The 32-year-old Tanya Hamilton McDonald, otherwise called Sassy, she was a businesswoman of Dolphin Cove, Dolphin Bay in Portland, and y'all already know how she was found. Based on ongoing investigation, McDonald has been fingered in matters of a similar nature. The Gleaner says that, hear this. The Gleaner says that the popular Portland businessman Everton Beachy Stout has been charged and they told you what he was charged for. Him and two other men were taken into custody in connection with what happened to the wifey, right? Well, to Sassy. Now, according to police sources, investigators are saying that they have a clear picture of even the planning process that led up to the death of Tanya, aka, you know, Sassy, right? They have a clear picture, is what they're saying. How do they have a clear picture? They have a clear picture. The details are reportedly contained in a caution statement, which is their other word for an official confession or testimony, right? The details are contained in that caution statement that was recorded by detectives from one of the businessman's co-accused. So them went and pick him up first, and him start tell pon everybody, and I saw them go get Beachy Stout. You understand? We don't have to talk about how she was found and all that. We know it was shortly after 9 p.m. in our place named Sherwood Forest and all these things. Everton McDonald and his two co-accused, Donvalin Minot and Oscar Barnes, were taken into custody almost 2 weeks ago during a series of coordinated operations in Portland. Remember, the people were saying that that's the reason why, and the Portland police did come get him, you know. Okay, because of course we had it dragging on social media that they can't touch him in Portland, because even the police in Portland was in his pockets. So more than likely, he is going to get away. Well, this time, the justice system, JCF, must have been listening, because they said, ah, adata go on. All right then, so Irwa, we don't want Portland police deal with him. We are deal with him from way up top. And they went all the way down there and went and got him, right? The three accused killers challenged their continued detention through separate habeas corpus petitions that were filed by their attorneys in the Kingston and St. Andrew and in the Portland Parish Courts. So the three men, after they were arrested, them get a lawyer. I don't know who's the lawyer, but I'm willing to bet that it was one of them expensive lawyer there. The kind of lawyer where you pull out when you know the caca is about to hit the fan and you are in deep. So those lawyers had filed habeas corpuses on their behalf, and apparently those were rejected. A habeas corpus is, hey, charge my client or let them go. Well, the system said, the justice system, the JCF says, charge them or let them go. All right, them charge, because we have enough to hold them, right? Now, after hearing the applications, the court ordered that the men be charged by 5 p.m. on Tuesday or be released. Well, they said, no release for you. Not with this kind of insurmountable evidence against you. The businessman arrest has led police investigators to review the 2009 demise of his first wife, Merlene, who get dashwe right outside our house. Pop, 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 pop. I don't need to say the words, right? And here we are today. I know for a fact, so right now, people are saying, see there, God not sleep. Long run, short catch, Mr. Man. Long run, short catch. From the start, this case actually seemed like it was a paid hit, and it turned out that it exactly was so. We're not going to talk too much more about this for now, because there's a whole lot more that's left to come, and I want the person who is giving me the information to actually come forward. I'm waiting on them. When them drop the information and give me the go-ahead. Actually, I have some more voice notes, and I have some more info, but I have not been given permission to release them. Matter of fact, I have been asked to hold off on them until certain things happen. This is one of the certain things that he was waiting on, or she was waiting on, that gave me the information. So now that it has happened, I'm waiting on that link, and we're going to give you some more. You're not hear half of the story yet, people. Trust me, when you hear the rest of this, you're gonna hold your head and say, Jesus Christ Almighty God, whoa. Anyway, yeah man, long run, short catch. Now he'll be placed before a court of law and he will have his day in court. Don't forget though, he's still innocent until proven guilty, right? Let's see what will happen here. And y'all know Jamaica don't rush no court case because a man get charged in 2013 and never get convicted until 2020. So I don't know if they're going to have Beachy Stout sitting in a prison or jail rather for years before he actually goes to trial on this charge or what. Let's see. It's SoFlo TV. Leave your comments in the comment section below. And don't forget, like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell next to the subscribe button. And then click the option that says send me all video uploads. Because when we release the rest of what we have, you don't want to miss it. And if you are not notified properly, it's because you're probably not subscribed properly. Catch you on the next video. Walk good, people. Walk good. One love.